Hello, everyone, and welcome to Storytime with Wings Over the Rockies. My name is Carissa, and today we are going to read Moon's First Friends. One Giant Leap for Friendship. Written by Susanna Leonard Hill, with pictures by Elisa Paganelli. So Moon's First Friends. Ooh, got some stars going on. The moon was queen of the night sky. She was so bright that everything she touched glowed with silver light. But after many, many years had passed, she was lonely. "If only someone would come visit me," she said. "Hello down there," she called to the lumbering dinosaurs. "If you come up here, you won't feel so heavy. You'll feel lighter than air." But the dinosaurs stayed where they were. Under the moon's watchful eye, the surface of the earth changed. The moon saw glorious new creatures come and go. Saber-toothed tigers, mastodons, woolly mammoths, dodo birds, whales, rhinoceroses, and elephants. But they all stayed earthbound, rarely looked up to her in the night sky. I bet that made the moon kind of sad. Let's find out what happens next. Ooh, but then something new. At night, people conjured fires like tiny stars. "There are millions of stars for you up here," she offered. But the people stayed where they were. The moon watched as she circled and circled the earth. On the wide sweep of the hot Sahara, the Egyptians built stone pyramids that towered towards the sky. "They're trying to reach me," the moon marveled. But though the pyramids were mighty, they came nowhere near high enough to reach the moon. Perhaps they didn't see her. She spun and twirled from new moon to majestic silver pearl and back again, showing off for the people below. But no one came. I like it when the moon changes in the night sky. I think it's fun to watch. She watched as down below on the earth, people came up with all kinds of ways to get from one place to another. But they did not sail, or drive, or cycle, or float to the moon. Then, on a windy day in North Carolina, the first airplane flew above a beach. "You're doing great," encouraged the moon. "You just need to fly a little higher." But the people on Earth only traveled to visit one another. Was it possible they didn't know she was there? At high noon, the moon slipped purposefully between the Earth and the sun, blocking all the daylight. Then she slid aside again, allowing the sun to shine through. No one could have missed that, she thought. But still, no one ventured from Earth. Would she ever have a visitor? Just when the moon was losing hope, the people on Earth began to experiment with rockets. And the moon watched with great interest. But the humans still had a lot to learn. One day, the moon's hopes soared. A chimpanzee in a Mercury capsule rocketed toward her. A visitor, at last! But alas, he returned to Earth without reaching her. Ooh, but they're getting closer. I bet the moon's pretty excited. And then, one hot July day, a tremendous rocket stood upon a launch pad with two small spaceships perched on top. The countdown began. You guys want to count with me? All right, we'll go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, liftoff! At 30 stories high and weighing 6 million pounds, the rocket rose into the air amid an explosion of flames. Slowly at first, and then faster and faster, the rocket fell away in stages, but the two spaceships hurtled toward the moon. "They're coming," the moon said. "They're actually coming." Look how excited she is. That's pretty cool. One of the spaceships remained at a distance, circling. But the other came closer, closer, until at last its spindle legs touched down. "Welcome," she greeted the men who emerged from the ship. Ooh, see what they do. The astronauts walked across her surface with great bounding steps that made her dust bloom. They seemed delighted with how far they could travel with each stride. The moon gave them gifts of rocks and dust. "Take these back to Earth," she said. "Then, even though I can't visit you, a part of me will be there." The men left her a present in return, a handsome plaque that read, "Here, men from the planet Earth first set foot upon the moon, July 1969 AD. We came in peace for all mankind." It's actually on the moon, you guys. It's pretty cool. They also left her a beautiful flag with red and white stripes and a scattering of white stars on a blue background. Too soon, the astronauts had to leave. "Goodbye," said the moon as their ship floated away into the starry distance. "Come back soon." She sighed with happiness. At last, someone had visited. Look, they're waving back to her. And now she had hope that it would happen again and again. Maybe one day you will visit her. We've been to the moon a few times. Now our next big step is trying to get to Mars. Maybe you guys will be able to go to the moon and to Mars. That would be pretty cool. Well, thank you all for joining us for Moon's First Friends, another story time with Wings Over the Rockies. I've been Carissa. I hope you guys all have a great day.